Königssee in Bavaria. Huge crowd here at the oldest natural ice track in the world as we get ready for the Blue Ribbon event here just outside the town of Berchtesgaden. It's the four-man bobsleigh World Cup, round four of the FIBT Viessmann World Cup Tour, and it's the first of our two runs. Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining us wherever you are. Beautiful snowy scenes here at the lake that gives this track its name. I'm Martin Haven, alongside me, John Morgan. And John, Christoph Langen last night promised us track records on this Königssee track today.
Well, it's a short 1,200 meter track, that four-corner S combination, and the cries on the labyrinths down below are the real challenges, pivotal parts of the track. But like in every bobsled race, it's the first 50 meters. You have to have the athletes get in, get down, and it's short and quick compared to Altenburg a week ago where the athletes ran a long ways. Getting in, get down before this first corner, the speed on the exit of that first corner is gonna be everything in this race. Also, the exit of this four S curves, right, left, right, left. And you wanna exit, when it's smooth, it's like a slingshot to the bottom part of the track, sets you up for this big 280 degree whip around, they call the Kreisel. The G-forces in here are extreme, but it is also an extreme on the sleds and the suspensions. Maxed out, and then they come into this tight corner at the bottom, and then Ekelvon all the way at the finish, another almost four plus Gs of force. And you have to exit here perfectly because you go uphill for the last 150, 200 meters of the track. Martin, looks like a great day coming upon us.
Absolutely. Oscars Melbardis is our World Cup points leader. Great streak of form he's had so far. One of three different winners in the four-man in the three events so far. Alexander Kazyanov has been consistent, but not yet a race winner. Well, we've got all sorts of possibilities. He's had four different nations win in the four events so far this weekend. We could get our second German winner. We could get our first Latvian winner. Who knows? Well, Nico Walter yesterday, a standout in the two-man race, again on the podium. He won last week for the first time ever. And there is the man who lies second in the World Cup standings. The Russians underperformed a little yesterday. Their best two-man driver was, in fact, Alexei Stulnev, the third-string Russian. Stephen Holcomb in the middle of the pack there, everybody warming up by the huge new start facility here that was built three or four years ago. And crowds everywhere around this track. Well, Nick Cunningham gets start draw number one for the USA. Lamin Dean has never started as high up the order as he does. Second for Great Britain, Rico Pater. And then a little further down, our World Cup points leader, Chris Springer, Canada, 11th place on the start draw. We have 22 sleds from 12 nations getting ready to compete here in Germany. Königssee, Bavaria, race four at the FIBT Viessmann World Cup for four-man bobsled. Martin Haven, John Morgan, just above the finish area and right at the top of the track is Nick Cunningham from Monterey, California, US Army slider, 5th, 12th and 16th, his three four-man races so far this season. Joined by David Kremen, grad student Alex Harrison at 3 and Sam Michener at 4.
U.S. team has shuffled up their lineups every week. Cunningham might have had his worst race of his four-man career last weekend in Altenburg, driving one of the two night train sleds in the field. This night train won the gold medal in Vancouver in 2010. Here's our first team down of the day. Well, the start is, it's quick. You gotta get in, get down, get around this first curve, settled. Watch the speed in the left, 43.4. But the more important speed is after the first curve, right here in the left. This is the telltale sign. That's gonna tell you everything, the chances they have at the bottom.
Well, we saw three track records in the women's race, the first three sleds down on what was then a very glassy track, well inside the track record. Top six in heat one were inside it. 123.6, this is very quick speeds indeed.
Watch out, a little late there. Boy, these four-mans, tough to get them into trouble, but when they get into trouble, unlike the two-mans, they don't come back.
122.4, we could see up to 125 kilometers now at the bottom of the track. Cunningham setting the marker for everyone else with a 49.31 slide.
66 hundredths off the track record. I think we're going to get close to that track record today.
Well, we were chatting to Manny Mahata last night at a big reception in the centre of Berchtesgaden. He's the man that holds the track record from the World Champs in 2011. But in the reception, Christoph Lang was saying the track is as quick.
Laid off here off the Kreisel. Watch the sled come across, though. He really wanted to get on early in this S combination. And boy, it came through here pretty good, pretty smooth compared to the two-man sleds.
Well, we saw two of the three U.S. women crash in the two-man race there, didn't we? So,
but they were doing track records.
They know the danger. Well, we could be in track record territory here as well. Next up from Great Britain, Lamin Dean, the Grenadier Guardsman, started his bobsledding career as a brakeman. Been driving for 4 years now. Behind him, Toby Alubi, whose first ever start was yesterday. Jordan Smallin, who pushed Oddie Bidov's sled in the two-man. And Andy Matthews on the back. Pete Gunn, the coach there, cleaning the spikes. He promised me that he will wear a kilt for the World Championships. It's out there, Pete. You've got to do it now.
Four great athletes on this sled, but they're just paired together in their first competition. It wasn't a smooth get in, and now look at them banging off the wall. Watch the speed, 63.3, what the U.S. had. But the U.S. had a smooth entry. Look at that, eight tenths of a kilometer down, and it's all related to how they got in the sled.
Two four-man races so far this season. 12th in Lake Placid, a great fifth place finish in Calgary.
Speed. 123.6 the Americans had. This is pretty good considering their initial entry into the sleds.
Good exit as well from the Kreisel. Nailed on down through the lower labyrinth. We're going to see 124s here, 122.9, a whisker quicker. Still behind, 1600s, 1800s, could be 2 tenths back from Nick Cunningham at the line.
That's all.
1700s.
All relative to the mistake at the start where they looked like Toby Obu did not get in smoothly. He'll be on the left side of our screen.
Great woman Anya Kay raced yesterday,
right,
helping with the sleds.
Now watch the left side of the screen. Now watch Toby's entry with his feet onto the side panel. See how smooth this is. Up, see his other foot came down, almost hit the ice. That delayed him getting in. And now he just drives into the wall here, and this is not how to do it. I think they ran too far, Martin. This is a shorter start.
Well, again, it's the first race they've had together as a foursome.
This is pretty good exit, though. Very smooth compared to Cunningham on the exit of Kreisel.
Well, there's Lamin Dean, day job protecting the queen. Next up, Rico Pater, the 31-year-old from Switzerland. Broer van der Zijde at two raced last year for the Netherlands. Thomas Amrein and Fabian Baujan. Rico Pater having a great season in two-man and four-man, lies third in the World Cup standings at the moment. He was third last week on the podium in Altenburg.
I bet you these Swiss athletes get in, get down quick. Watch them. Boom. Look at that. They're already in and down before the British were still running. Look at that. 4:85 start. Now, you're probably going to see close to 64-kilometer speed here. 63, that's not that. For 800s better than the U.S., to only be 2 tenths better, I think that they didn't have a greatest entry into the sled. And only to be 1300s up there.
Well, let's see what he can produce. Rattles down the straightaway into the Kreisel turn. 124.2,
good speed. That's good speed, though. That's what he's been doing. He's been manufacturing speed.
Well, we saw the Brits 122.9 at the bottom.
This is really good.
This sittiest four-man sled. 123.4, very good speed.
Lost 100 back there, but this is definitely the leader.
1900s at the line.
Still don't like why they did not have better velocity out of the curve one. That's related to the way the driver enters that curve. There's a little bump on that curve one. We'll be seeing that. But just because you got the best start time doesn't mean you're going to have the best speed at the exit curve.
Well, you
one.
Have to sit down in front of the man in front. So four must sit down before three can, before two can. So it starts from the back. So you often see the man right behind the driver hung out late.
And this is the long straightaway. It's not a straightaway. You can see it's a big bend, but it's a straight bend. And you have to hit a couple times before you get in to the next curve, and you know, Doesn't seem like there's a perfect way in and out of that curve. And look at this here. This is a little late in the bottom. This is where he lost his time back.
Yeah, little bump. Otherwise, he'd have been quarter second in front.
Yeah, he was 21 hundredths, went back to 19.
So three of our 22 sleds down, 12 different nations competing. And next up is Canada's Justin Cripps, 28-year-old, born in Hawaii, now from Summerland in British Columbia. Third yesterday in the two-man race that he won last year in two-man.
Good athletes. I mean, there's great athletes on every sled. They got in quick, but the guy slipped, the number three guy.
Yeah, Brian Barnett, who was on the two-man sled yesterday.
Let's see if that cost him 63.5, 63.3, same as Cunningham. And he was better by Cunningham by 400.
Well, we both talked to Justin after the race yesterday. He said, what is it about this track? He said, I just like it.
He says he likes the challenge below the Kreisel.
123.7, good speed, second quickest.
Good crossover, back in, good. Now watch the bottom part of the track. You guys got to get Echo Von.
Losing
speed. Look at this coming up the hill here. Oh, he's way back.
Well, he's third place at the moment, but might be fourth. Third of the line, 3/10 back, just in front of Lamin Dean of Great Britain. Well, no sign of the track record yet. Track record 48.65.
Just hold your breath. Next guy. Hold your breath. Next guy coming up. You know, he doesn't have the same confidence. So watch the mistake here on the left. He collided with his teammate.
Yeah.
You know, again, this is a four-man bobsled start. Choreography on ice. You have to do it hundreds of dry land training in the summer.
Yeah.
And then bring it out to the ice track.
And of course, this is the season when you're swapping brakemen around, mixing and matching teams. Well, next up is our World Cup points leader, junior world champion in two and four man in 2012, Olympic silver medalist in February last year, Oskars Melbardis of Latvia. Started as a brakeman behind Yanis Minins, who coaches the Russians now. Converted to driving in 2010 after the games. His record this year, bronze, gold, silver. Not off the podium. There is his former driver.
Three decathletes and a basketball player here. You probably could see 479. 476 is the track record at the start. This is the first team that has a chance to challenge.
And this is the team that set it last year.
481. Now watch this speed. This has got to be 64 and change. 64 flat. I thought they'd be better.
Still comfortably the fastest team we've seen down into the S's.
Now the speed should be 124 and a half.
Three taps. The third one sets you up for the left.
124.7.
Very good speed.
Now the crossover as he comes out. Oh, perfect.
Top speed, the bottom, 123.4.
But he didn't extend his speed away from there,
123.8.
Now can he be smooth at the bottom? Oh, he's losing time back.
1800's up, could be 2/10 at the line. It is 2/10 at the line, 48.92. Still 3/10 away.
Well, he outdrove Rico Peter because Peter was 400 slower at the start and Melbardis 2/10 at the bottom. You know, we're nowhere near the record, and I think this would have been the first rabbit would have given us a good indication if it was a chance. Watch these four huge men. Look at their hands. Look at their waiting. The number two guy's waiting for the three guy to get settled. Watch their arms come up. This is the choreography on ice, almost exact.
There you go, 4-3-2, bing, 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 in they
these
drop.
These are the Olympic silver medalists from last year. This team's intact. Look how high he gets here on the bottom.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a high line, and he had good speed down there.
Well, it's nice cold air, which means it won't be too frosty up on the track. Melbardis has the lead. He's our World Cup points leader. Five down, 17 to come. Alexander Kazyanov of Russia, the economist from Bratsk. Only 14th yesterday in the two-man, really couldn't find his mojo. But fourth in the Olympics in the four-man. He's been second in Lake Placid, eighth in Calgary, fifth last week in Altenburg. Time to get back on the podium for the Russians.
Start times have been suspect.
In neatly though, look at that, 488, and no rocking and rolling of the sled.
Left side of the screen, 63.7, half a kilometer down to the Latvians. I had a few beers last night with Jenny Popoff and Alexander Zubkov. Wonderful reception at the German Federation through last night in downtown Birch's Garden.
Four taps down the
track. That's big speed, though.
Yeah, he had a big steer, though, going into Jenna. 800's back.
That's not bad. That's not bad. He could get him on the bottom. Speed's about the same.
Exactly the same.
Now to four. This is going to the 100. Good drive from Kazanov.
Is it the Vimmer sled? No, it's not.
He'll take it, though.
Yeah.
That's what we've been missing out of him the last couple events. After he just missed winning the gold medal in Lake Placid by 1/100th of a second to Max Arndt, I thought this was going to be a big season for him. So maybe somebody turned the light bulb on. Look at the lines here. He hung it on the fourth S. Bang.
What's the runner tips here? He has a big steer.
And he realizes three bangs. Back end of the skid, fourth hit.
That cost him the lead right there.
Well, he's
that mistake alone.
700s behind at the top, only two at the bottom.
Yeah, that was a good drive from him. Next up, former Olympic champion Stephen Holcomb won the gold in 2010. The soldier from Park City has had a middling season this year. 6th, 7th, and 9th. His World Cup results in four-man. And again, mixing the crew, Justin Olsen, James Reed, and Carlo Valdez. They were the same crew that were in Altenburg. But the US coach is like everybody else, John, using this fallow year, if you like, to try and get the right balance.
Steve Holcomb in the night train won this event last year, the last event, the 40 Olympics, but Holcomb's not getting the same starts. Fifth best start in speed. Oh, look at that bump in that first curve. Oh, that could have hurt him. 63.5 speed is not bad, though, considering the deficient start time. He was comfortable in training, but he's way back here. Speed. 123.7. It's a kilometer down to the top sleds.
Holcomb's win in Königssee last year was the first by an American in a four-man in World Cup in Germany. In Königssee, rather.
In Königssee, yeah.
123.5, decent speed.
He's not even going to match his teammate.
Fourth place, 49.2. Just in front of Cunningham by 1100s.
Well, his had the best start here last year in the competition.
Yeah.
So he's 1000s down at the start. You give him that 1300s at the bottom, and he's in the lead. So that's the difference between Steve Holcomb on the podium and Steve Holcomb top 10 is start time. Look at the entrance. Watch the sled go airborne here, curve one. That is really misleading. We'll see how the German sleds get into that first curve. Boy, they're all making this pretty easy down here. Back end of the sled here, what does he do? Does it come up?
Well, Holcomb lies in fourth position out of seven sleds so far. Next up, Germany's Max Arndt, the reigning world champion in four-man from Suhl near the Oberhof track. First in Lake Placid, bronze medalist in Calgary, crashed in Altenburg, big crash as well. Concussed, knocked out. German doctors have cleared him to race this weekend, though.
Won't be the best start. It should be in the high 80s, at least. 87, expected. Watch him enter. See, he didn't have that hit up in the air like Holcomb did. 63.8, better. Pretty good velocity, too. But Max, doctor this week, still had a pretty good cut on his nose.
Yep.
Pretty tough hit. Speed, 124 to have a chance. 125.5!
Oh, here we go.
Here, game on here. This is it.
Coming from a 10th back to 100 behind. Yeah.
Watch out, 124 speed.
125 at the bottom as well, 124-1.
This is going to be the leader, wow.
In the green, how much will he lead by?
Any doubts about Max Art? Wow. Yeah, full, says Christoph Lund. Any doubts about him? Those are good guns.
Yeah.
He's back on track, as expected. And he knows he's fighting with those two other German athletes to be the Germany number one pilot.
Well, to be in the team, because there's a whole new crowd coming up from underneath as well.
Max, good job.
Well, here's the first of our three German drivers.
Start, look at the feet coming down exactly the same. Alexander Rodeker on the left. He used to fly down the track with a good friend, Andre Lange. Look at the way the heads are buried in there. Boy, did he have unbelievable speed. 2 kilometers better than Holcomb. Kilometer better than the other two sleds. That's why he's the leader.
Four-man world champion Max Art leads the field here. Teammate Francesco Friedrich, who's the two-man world champion and was the 2013 junior four-man world champion as well, is next up. 24 years old now, so still actually a junior from Pirna, just outside Altenburg. 14th in Lake Placid, silver medalist in the four-man in Calgary. Only 6th last weekend in Altenburg, his home ice.
For 80. Wow. Speed was 64. Magical start speed. Now it's up to him to watch the runner tips here on the exit of this 4th S.
Yeah, you're gonna have to get that guy's head back out of the way.
Only three hits. 125 speed. Oh, that's the wrong clock there.
900 up. Yeah, that's definitely not the right speed. More than 87 there.
500s on the bottom. Oh, but he had a hard hit. The exit of the S's. 123.2 is not very good. This is definitely looking at least top.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe not even going to have the lead at the line.
Yes,
100.
By 100.
Oh, is right.
Well, the secret there is he started 700s better than Max Arndt. And only won by 100th at the bottom.
That one hit down in the lower labyrinth took away the speed that he needed to climb the hill to the finish line.
Look at the crowd here.
Yeah. It's like 8 deep down that bend away at the wall.
Look at the entrance to curve one now. We talk about it. Look at the way he steered around.
Ooh.
He got a little bit what Holcomb did.
Yeah. He had a skid as he tried to steer. Didn't actually
watch
take.
The back end of the sled here too. I think he lost some time here. Watch him come airborne there. See the back right runner? That wasn't as smooth as Arndt or Mel Bardis.
Well, things to clear up for Francesco Friedrich. He lies second, Germany 1-2 at the moment. Next up, Oscar Kiebermannis, the 21-year-old. Made his World Cup debut here 2 seasons ago. Came straight in as a driver. Was never a great man. Big fan of AC/DC. Most of the Latvian team are big rock fans.
Are we seeing some snow come down?
It's falling out the trees above us. 10th, 4th, his 2 World Cup races. Did not race in Altenburg last week.
A bunch of clouds coming in, though.
Yeah, a little bit of cloud cover, but it's otherwise a beautiful day. A little bit of snow dropping in off the trees just in front of our window.
It's 4 decathletes here. Watch these guys rock it. Latvians have brought the best athletes in their country into this sport. And watch the start time, 4:81. The 2 best starts in the competition, won by the Germans at 80, and by DeBartis and Kiebermannis both at 81.
Good momentum as well, 64 kilometers an hour. New guy, Helvis Lucis, only his 2nd World Cup race on the 2 on the sled, but he just fitted in as part of a well-oiled machine. Yeah.
Not bad speed. Kiebermannis is not the driver Mel Bardis is yet.
Well, Mel Bardis is 2 seasons in front of him, isn't he? So
this is pretty good. If he gets a good speed here at the bottom.
4th place at the moment, Mel Bardis is 3rd.
This is really good. Oh, but I made a mistake there, going uphill. Lost a lot, lost 6 800s down there in the bottom. Still not bad.
top five. We've got Germany, Latvia, Russia, Latvia, and then the best of the Swiss sleds ahead of two Americans and a Canadian. First of our 10 sleds, first 10 of our sleds down here in Königssee, Bavaria.
Watch this uphill section on the bottom part of the track out of Eckelvond. Now watch how high he gets here, and the sled flops a little bit, comes over, hits the left-hand wall. The sled, you can't do that. That's going uphill, that's lethal.
Big bump there, takes the speed out of the sled. Well, there is Oscar's keeper, man. It's just a tenth behind his teammate, Oscar's Melbardis, as they vie for the medals. Francesco Friedrich, 100th in front of Max Arndt. Germany 1-2, 12 sleds to come in heat one. Well, keeper Manis, a tenth of a second. That might be accounted for his deficit to his teammate by the 2 years more experience as a driver that Oscar's Melbardis has. But keeper Manis is the real deal at the moment. He is definitely going to be in the hunt for medals in the second heat. See little patches of sunshine on the mountains are all around us.
Stays like this, excuse me. You're going to see Latvians, two sleds, challenging for medals in Korea. Because I think keeper Manis, every week we come out here, he seems to get more proven. Of course, if you've got a start time like he's got, you have a chance to be good. If you have no start time, you have no chance.
Yeah.
Unless you're Elfie Williamson from Belgium.
Well, we see the crowds down here. Max Arndt being interviewed on the finish dock below us for the crowds in the grandstand. That was going all the way around the track as well, giving his thoughts. Big smile on his face. Always a very sunny, happy character, Max Arndt. And definitely a great ambassador for German bobsledding. Francesco Friedrich, Max Arndt, 1 and 2.
One thing I noticed about Max Arndt being interviewed here, his nose has cleared up a lot. I saw him on Wednesday. He got quite a scab still on his nose, and that's all cleaned up. Looks good.
Well, that's good to hear, and good that the German doctors passed him okay on Sunday night, because he had a big hit on the head, was knocked out in the sled. Big crowd here, very knowledgeable crowd. Loads of kids here as well today. Hundreds and hundreds of school kids out, taking in all the action. So it's always a big day when you come to town in Berchtesgaden. This is a sliding town. The Luge fraternity are based here. And it's a huge sliding sense of a German bobsledding and skeleton as well. Berchtesgaden in Bavaria. We're just outside the sliding center of Germany at the Königssee track. 11th of our 22 sleds in the first of our two heats here. The four-man World Cup is Chris Springer, Canada, 30-year-old former Aussie cricketer. 10th are his three four-man results this season. Again, the Canadians mixing and matching their crew. They've got Josh Kirkpatrick on the brakes for the first time, joining Derek Plug and Alexander Kopacz in the sled.
Well, those three 10th place finishes are relative to his start times. Probably should be in the low 90s. There's flat 90, it's not bad. Speed, they were in the sled pretty well. So they 63.5, 63.4 expected. Now, Chris Springer, he's a good driver. Not there though.
Corrected the skid nice and quickly though, back end in the breakaway. They've got nice thin runners on the back as well for maximum control.
Speed off the pace, boy, big wiggle there too in the crash. Back end of the sled, a little bit of a bump. Boy, he's had some transition. There too, big hit there. Speed way off.
3Ks down.
Yeah. The question is how many can he beat Lamont Dean of Great Britain?
10th place run for Chris Spring, no. Behind Lamont Dean, 11th place out of 11 sleds.
Just no speed. And all the way down the track. Considering.
And we saw all the errors that added up to that 11th place.
He had the 7th best start time. Like his teammate, he tied Justin Cripps. So the 7th best start, you should have the 7th best finish, minimum. So.
Well, Cripps made a couple of errors. Chris Spring a couple more than that, I think.
Look at the back end of the sled here. That's what the contact with the ice here. Bang, look at the little bit of runner-up, and then look at the transition, you know. A lot of pressure on the driver, the brakeman, on that spot. Look at these pictures.
And also, of course, on the runners, really driving them into the ice, and that helps to slow you down a bit as well.
Look at that, the front runner was airborne there. That's tricky down there. The skeleton people call it the doodles. I'm starting to like that.
Yeah. Well, next up, the man who claimed gold last week in Altenburg in the four-man race. His standout performance of the year so far. Nico Walter with Andy Bredo, Marco Hubenbeck and Christian Poser. Bredo and Poser, part of the track record-setting crew.
Oh, sled rocked there out of the start. Well, these two guys, Bredo and Huckenberger, are both 6 foot five, 6 foot six, 483, not bad. Now watch the speed here. I think Huckenberger really provides some great energy. 64, good speed. This guy was magical last week. Magical yesterday in the two-man.
Yep.
Oh, he's only 100 down.
Two gold medals in this last two starts.
Only two hits.
Right in the frame.
Big speed.
Fantastic speed. Fastest we've seen.
Crossover. What's the back end of the sled?
Smooth for the lead.
Real smooth. Now
speed, this high 124s. 124.9.
He's got the lead.
Going to be a couple of hundreds in it. We're going to have German 1-2-3 here in Königssee, and that's the first time we've seen that this year.
Wow. Dead heat, dead time. No, he's 100th ahead. The top three sleds are separated by 200ths of a second.
And they're all German.
A little different than last year's performance here.
Yeah. A little different than in North America as well. Now they're in their heartland. Nico Walter leads, and this is why.
Skid, though, surprised at that line. But boy, he only had two taps here. We've seen Holcomb come through with four taps. Look at the speed. Arndt was a rocket ship.
Yes, he was.
But boy, did I think Nico Walter's starting to figure things out.
Yeah, he's really starting to come of age now, isn't he? And the scary thing is he's only 24. Well, only 20 years old, and he's definitely a junior. Cody Baskew from Whitehall, New York. Aaron Victorian. Huge starts with Cody yesterday in the two-man, and they're joined by Adam Clark and Adrian Adams on this four-man US sled.
I think we got some snow coming down, Martin. Oh, lazy getting in there. They still aren't down yet. 596, 12 best. So if he gets his 63 flat. Now Cody crashed twice in four-man this week in training. Did pretty good in the two-man in the first run yesterday. Ooh, this isn't good. He's got a big skid, that four-man sled.
That's exactly what he had in the two-man in the second heat, isn't he? Sideways down the straightaway.
Doodle, that's where his problems are. The exit here. Oh, almost.
That was a wild
that
ride.
Was, I'll tell you what, about all three of those guys in the back of that sled felt that. This isn't about, this is just getting down, getting this young 20-year-old from Whitehall, New York, some experience, and he's, as he's been doing all along, he's doing great.
Well, Lana Myers-Taylor was due to race in the four-man. She crashed a couple times in training, had to use her remaining runs to guarantee a spot in the women's
race. She crashed in two-man, though. She never got to practice in a four-man.
So she needed to get those two-man runs in, so she won't race in the four-man, and actually after crashing out of the women's race, I bet she's glad of that this weekend.
These are all guys just starting to get put together. This cohesion is about in the summertime. Now watch the guy on the right. It's Adam Clark. Look at that. He's waiting, looking, can't get in. The brakeman got in way, sat down way before Adam Clark could. So they had a little bit of a Chinese fire drill there. Now down here, now watch how airborne the sled gets here.
Oh. Yeah, Cody's out of the chair there as he hits the wall. Currently lying in 13 spots. Next up is Alexei Stulnev, the 27-year-old from Moscow. Brand new man at two. Stanislav Nystrup has not started before. Then Yuri Selikov and Alexei Zaitsev. 13th, 14th, 13th his results so far in four-man this year.
He's pretty good two-man yesterday.
He had a great time in the two-man yesterday.
Top three
absolutely.
After the first run and then fell away.
But a great first run.
Hey, the Russians are going to have another couple new drivers next week. Zakharov's going to come back next week in San Moritz. He's been hanging out there in the Europa Cup. 491 start. 63.6, 63.3, not a very good. We noticed this yesterday. The Russians didn't have very good start speeds. Not bad start times.
Yeah, in the reception yesterday, you pulled up Alexander Zubkov about the start speeds, didn't you? What was his answer?
No, I don't want to bring it up.
Yeah, speak to the performance coach.
Speeds, not bad. That's late there, though. That's pretty smooth through the doubles.
He's come up from 11th to 9th, but he's still 4 tenths behind. 122 is okay.
5,400's back. Might lose a couple more. Yeah, boy, he lost 10, 1100's coming up the last 150 meters.
Last he didn't have the speed below the doodles. Steering a little hard. He was the best of the three Russians in the two-man race yesterday by some margin.
Top four sleds, top five sleds, separated by 1600s. German's the top three of the people everybody's going to chase, but look how late he's running. He might be the new guy. Look at the number two guy. Wait for the guy at the number three. That was pretty good teamwork there.
Dropping
I thought the number two guy was three guy was running too far. Here, look at the teams. Look at the aerodynamic profiles. Look at the number three guy's up a little too high.
Ooh, bit of a skid. The back end trying to drop down in the Kreisel there. Don't want that. So there is Alexei Stulnev, 14th of our 22 sleds. Next up is his young teammate, 26-year-old Max Adrianov. Max only started the World Cup this season. It's only his second World Cup race. He was eighth last week in Altenburg. Clearly, one thing we know about him, no fear.
Notice the driver started up front on the push bar. Some of the guys go back to the block and they run forward. Ooh, there's a wave. 491's not bad.
That's same as his teammates.
Big bump there. Speed 63 low. Yeah, the Russians aren't getting good entries into the sled. Their start speeds are not good for the start times that they're getting.
Well, also 488, 491, 491. They're not setting the world alight in the starting area.
2200's back's not bad. Look, that's a wrong green clock there. That's the wrong speed clock there. We've got a little problem with that Kreisel. Seven, this is much like his teammate.
Well, he'll have been in the 124s in the Kreisel. 121.3 at the bottom.
Way off.
Yeah, transit speed all the way down.
The track also might be a little chewed up. Doesn't take long.
Yeah, these 700 kilo sleds make a tiny difference to the track, but enough for a few hundreds. Of course, next week when we go to the natural track in St. Moritz, it actually gets faster as the day goes on. So a later start draw will see higher speeds as the frost comes off. Adrianov in 14th place out of 15 sleds so far.
Watch the exit of Kreisel. Look at the heads. Look how smooth this is. That's very good exit. And then as he snakes his way through these labyrinth three-quarter combination, and boy, it's so tight in there. Look at the way the hard left is. That's tough on the guys riding 2, 3, and 4. That's your rib cage.
Feels real good in the bobsled. Nico Walter, Francesco Frujic, Max Arndt, 1, 2, 3 after our first 15 sleds in Königssee. Austria's Benny Meyer at the top of the track here in Königssee, Bavaria. Martin Haven, John Morgan at the finish area watching the action with you. Meyer, just 20 years old, from Rome outside Innsbruck. When he started bobsleigh in 2010, he was a skeleton slider before that, like his brother Raphael still is.
Had a crash in practice. Didn't want to talk about it. His number three guy, Sammer, was in the two-man competition yesterday as a driver.
Yeah, had a good run as well. Really nice lines from Marcus Sammer. one World Cup race so far this season from the Austrians. They were 15th last week in Altenburg. But from here, 16th down to 22. You've got seven sleds, looking for five spots. So it's all about getting into the race now.
This is where, oh, that's good speed right there. 124.9. Wow. This is pretty good time for him coming out of this position. Eighth, ninth place. Speed in the bottom's good.
Driving really nicely. Very good lines.
Boy, they'll be happy
eighth
with this.
Place at the line.
They'll love
seventh
that.
Place at the line.
Boy, the coach is young. Franz Josef Hoffman, who's from here in Berchtesgaden. He coaches the Austrians.
Well, we're so close to Austria. We're surrounded by Austria on three sides down here.
Listen to this.
Look at that.
He can't believe it. He's a 20-year-old.
So well.
Like Cody Beskid, 20 years old right here. You know, the really good, some good athletes that they've recruited, but the number three guy, that foot comes down, touches the ice. So again, not a lot of cohesion as we're going to see in two or three years from now.
Could have been
these are all brand
start,
new teams.
Yeah.
Brand new teams here.
He's in seventh place.
Speed on the bottom part of the track. Look at that. He's right up there with the big boys.
Well, those Austrian sleds do fly. They're very good at cheating the aerodynamics.
That one flies.
When I say cheating, I don't mean illegal. I mean beating the air at its own game. Well, next up, the only female driver in the race, Kaylee Humphreys, the 29-year-old double Olympic bobsleigh champion, DJ McClelland, Dan Dale, and Efrem Villalto, who joined her in Calgary for the two-man race, where she was 15th, are back on the sled again.
It's all about start time.
If they can break a 4.90, they'll be doing a really solid job.
5.12. Speed 62, probably.
What I would love to see is Oscar Smelvardis or one of the other Latvian crews behind her and see when they fire her off the deck on the steam catapult just how quickly she can drive this sled.
Yeah, but she's still got to give up 50, 60 pounds in the front seat as the driver. Not bad speed, though.
Very good speed, 123.6.
Yes, this is pretty good, actually. Good lines.
She's the double Olympic champion. We know she can drive.
Good lines. She knows how to come down this track. She's won on this track in 2 a.m. before.
Yeah. 49.81. Now, that should be enough to see her into the second heat. We'll have to wait and see how it goes. She's just 300s off Cody Baskew, who started 496.
Yeah, he started 1600s
better. The Canadian started
512. Yeah, he started 1600s better and only beat her by three at the bottom. So, Kaylee, right on.
Well, one thing we know about her is that the driving isn't the issue. It's getting enough muscle on the back to really start moving that sled. Kate O'Brien helping down there with the sled.
Get in, get down. Watch the arms come up. Number two guy waiting for the three guy. He didn't wait for the three guy to get down, so the three guy got down late.
It's only the second ever World Cup start for those three guys.
And they were struggling each other around and pushing each other around.
And
they weren't comfortable, yeah.
It's like you, me, and Edwin, the cameraman at the start, trying to get into a sled after a week's training. It's going to look ugly compared
Nico to the... Walter down there hanging out with him.
Absolutely. Well, next up, 29-year-old from Seoul, Yoon Jung-won of Korea. Started driving bobsleds in 2011. 13th place in Calgary. And the sled, well, the helmets are all Korean colors. Guess where the sled came from? If the orange on the front didn't tell you, the Netherlands logo down the side probably gave it away.
I think it's leased.
Red is indeed.
198.
Well, these guys have been zigzagging across Europe, going to all the tracks that we will race on for the remainder of the season. So they've had a week here, they've had a week in Lapland, a week in in Winterberg, a week in St. Moritz.
They've been doing great, the whole program. Skeleton, Bob, we haven't seen the woman's Bobs yet. I bet you we'll see them here in the next couple of weeks.
Just a little slower than Kaylee Humphreys into the Kreisel. And a faster start, but they're losing time back.
No speed, Kaylee, a kilometer and a half better. They lose a lot of time here in this uphill section.
Oh, but pulled up to 16th place by the line. So the speed misleading us there. He found good line out of the lower labyrinth and up through the final three corners. 16th place for him. He's ahead of Cody Baskew and Kaylee Humphries. They're 16th, 17th, 18th at the moment. Four sleds to go, only two places left in the race.
The size of these Koreans, their thighs, they brought some great athletes into the sport. Now it's just learning the technique. And here's a second hit. Then he comes over here and he's got a third hit. Then he's skidding. Then he's got a fourth hit. Remember, we saw Nico Walter come down two hits. Mel Bartis, two hits.
Yeah. Well, the Germans have the experience. This guy's only been on this track once for a week. Next up, Doran Grigore of Romania, the 29-year-old from Bucharest, raced last weekend in Altenburg, was 17th. Made his World Cup debut 3 years ago, having started in bobsledding in 2005. New brakeman at three, Gabriel Salihan joins Florin Kretschmann and Danut Moldovan.
Pretty good result, the two men in the first heat.
He was in that magic window, wasn't he, from 19, 20, 21, 22. Some really good lines and really good speeds as a result, despite the snow.
63.3 is pretty good
great
start
momentum,
speed,
yes.
Considering that deficient start time. Runner tips, so many times he's going to hit. And once, twice, three. He's a four-timer. Speed, not bad. Not great.
Same as Yoon Jung Won of Korea. He's gone from 14th at the start to 15th place.
Ooh, he's stuck through there.
Good line there. Keeps the speed on board. Well, he drove well in the two-man race. Driving well again.
Probably got the oldest piece of equipment in the competition.
16th place at the line. It is 16th place. Ahead of Won of Korea, ahead of Baskew.
They're celebrating because they're in the second run.
Absolutely.
And they do so much with so little, that Romanian team. And they have... They bring it all. They bring the every discipline, woman's bob, two-man bob. They bring all the athletes to the table, and they work with so much less than everybody else. A little late here, the crossover. A little late coming off there. These four-man sleds, it's tough to get them in trouble compared to the two-mans, which are like sports cars. Four-mans are like trucks. Tough to get a truck and a skid, but when it does,
it's tough to get it back. Well, next up for Italy is 26-year-old Lucas Schnitzer. Again, big surprise yesterday. I said to Coach Graham Richardson, don't think I've ever seen you quite so surprised with your trousers on. He's got Marco Rosa, Rocco Caruso, and Mattia Variola behind him. This is his first four-man race of the season. 16th yesterday was a great result after a standout first run. Former Alpine skier. Relatively late to bobsledding, just 4 years ago. See, even the start procedure sounds more romantic in Italian.
Clock 5:08, 19th. Best start, only Humphries was slower at the start. 62.3, that's not very good start speed, so he's going to have to, all he can do to beat Kaylee Humphries here at the bottom. That's not going to do it. Four hits, hard hits, speed, though the speed isn't bad, considering.
19th place at the moment, just in front of Kaylee Humphries. Her speed lower down, 122.6. Yeah. His 121.3.
Not very
it's
good.
It's going to be very tight.
I think he's
not.
He's going to fall behind Kaylee.
20th place at the line, so he is behind Kaylee Humphries.
By 600s.
Yep.
So Kaylee's got two more sleds.
Well, she could make it.
I think she's
going to
make it.
Bumped by both. It's unlikely, I have to say.
I think she's in.
I think she probably is too.
It was a men's world. Now.
Well, you can hear the track announcer chatting to Kaylee Humphries as the Italians ping-pong their way down the straight.
Quiet lines, decent speed in the Kreisel, but boy, in the bottom part of the track, he had nothing.
Yeah. 20th place for Lucas Schnitzer. That leaves him on the bubble. Nico Walter, Francesco Frugic, Max Arndt, the top three. They'll be last to go in the second and deciding heat. 20 sleds down, two to go. Let's now go fast or go home. Ollie Bidulph, Britain's development bobsleigh driver, his first World Cup four-man start. Fifth in the four-man in the Youth Olympic Games in Eagles, Austria in 2012. He's got Justin Orocampos, Keith McLaughlin, and Judas Simpson on the back of the stand. Now, there was a question over Judas' fitness this morning, and if he wasn't ready to go, Alicia Kittle, who raced in the women's race on Friday, was going to be on the back of the sled, but that has not been necessary, so... That would have been, I believe, the first ever start by a female brake woman in a World Cup race. That has yet to come.
Technique, not bad. Start time, not great. See if they can get to 63 kilometers speed. No, way off the pace. Kaylee Humphries, I think, had better speed.
They're battling with Kelly Humphries and Lucas Schnitzer to get into the race now. 19th at the start, 20th place as they get to the bend away.
123 at least, no, doesn't have that. So I don't think this sled is going to beat either one of the sled, any sled that's down the track right now. No, he's going to be at least 1.3 behind.
21st spot, 121.3, only the same speed as the Italian, so it's going to be hard to catch them without greater velocity. 21st place at the line, Ollie Bidulph is the first, who will not make the second heat. Coach Lee Johnson in the red cap, the development coach for Great Britain bobsleigh. He's got a portfolio full of young drivers, champing at the bit to get into the top cadre.
Well, it came down with the 19th best start, and he finished 21st. So if you got the 19th start, you should finish 19th or better. A little drift there at the, you know, his guys weren't settled at all. Now here out of the Kreisel, into the Doodles, the three-corner little tiny combination here. Watch the back end of the sled. That's pretty smooth. Maybe too smooth.
Well, as Ollie Bidulph finishes 21st, it means that Kaylee Humphries will be in the second heat because there's only one sled left and she's 19th. Jurjaan Vesselink of the Netherlands, 25-year-old from Laren, with Tim Balvers, Rudy Mensing and Dennis Finke behind. Former soccer player, his girlfriend is Maria van Hugenbosch, who is the Dutch female bobsleigh driver. And their coach, Michael Cerise, the former bobsled driver for France and Belgium, had his birthday yesterday. So bon fête to him.
Pretty proficient here. 5:17, the worst start of the competition.
But so they've got their hands full. Still trying to settle. He had his arms in, but he was still trying to wriggle himself in. Yeah. Get his legs around the driver.
So he's going to have some magical eyes and hands here at the bottom part of the track to make the cut. Look at the heads behind him. You can see the ball bouncing around. So, hey, he's a brand new guy in the competition. Great to see him out here. He got a lot of confidence.
He had a good run in the snow yesterday. I talked to him afterwards. He said, oh, we were lucky. I said, listen, luck's going to deal you a lot more bad hands. Take it when it gives you a good one and smile.
Yeah. All about it. Riding in the sled, you can see the head bouncing around a little bit. Threw it down. It's their first ever World Cup. Congratulations to this young, upcoming Dutch pilot.
Well, there's the coaches. Both of them you'll recognize, former drivers. Edwin van Kalk, who retired just before Christmas, and Michael Cerise. Well, they got into the heat. They got into the second heat in their first ever World Cup start yesterday in the two-man. They miss it in the four-man. On balance, still a good weekend.
Start. But they wait. Look at the number two guy wait. It was well-schooled here.
Yeah, he's trying to get his legs around the driver's
seat. But they're way out, way too late, you know, for him to be sitting down on that pressure point there.
He just couldn't get his feet in.
Yep.
Well, there is Jurjaan. Welcome to the World Cup, young man. So our race is being led by three German sleds covered by 200s. Will Christoph Langen still be smiling at the end of heat two? Nico Walter, winner yesterday, winner in the four-man in Altenburg, is leading after the first of our two heats.
Good start times, good down times. Nico Walter went 12th in the competition. He'll have more of an equal ice. He definitely looks like the guy everybody's going to be chasing, not only today, but for a few more weeks to go.
The World Championship shaping up nicely for him. There is your leaderboard. Anyone, maybe if the top eight could be in the medals, but realistically, we're looking at those top five still in with a shout at the win. Below that, Stephen Holcomb, Nick Cunningham, Justin Cripps, too far away to be in the medals, but there are some very close battles in our top 20. In the second heat, they go 20 down to 1 in reverse order of their first heat performance. The leader goes last, and Oddie Biddulph, Jurjen Vesselink and their crews will be watching from the sidelines with the packed grandstands here at Königssee in Bavaria. Join John Morgan and me, Martin Haven, for the second heat. That comes up but 4 local, 3 Greenwich Mean Time. Till then, from Königssee, for the moment, it's goodbye.
I just heard that your Bob is not the youngest. How old is your Bob?
He's 18 years old.
18 years?
Yeah, 18 years. It's the only thing we have. The 2 men, it's okay. It's